Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. Already Monday, the 19th day of May 2014, and we're going to be live here for the next 3 hours. If you go up to drudgereport.com, I still believe it's there, correct? If you go to drudgereport.com, right in the middle column is a story that went up Friday night that I thought was so important that I continued to keep it up on the front page of Infowars.com till last night. And I'm going to ask, and I rarely do that, I'm going to ask the writers to repost that red-linked to the front page of Infowars.com right now. But right now, you can find it at drudgereport.com in the middle of the middle column, police now armed for war against returning veterans. And this five-minute video clip from Fox News in Morgan County, Indiana, illustrates everything we've been talking about. And, of course, it's been said that one man dies, it's a tragedy, 10,000 dies a statistic, to quote Joe Stalin. We can have all the Army documents in the world that are admitted to be declassified and real, with the military training to confiscate our guns and arrest libertarians, conservatives, veterans, gun owners. But when you actually have them on the news rolling it out like it's a good thing, saying the next war won't be with the Muslim radicals, it won't be with Russia, it will be with the veterans. And they sell it like it's a good thing. This is something directly out of The Running Man. And then you see the dramas, the sitcoms, the movies. The cultural rollout is, who are patriots that like George Washington, private property, the Second Amendment, family values, men are men, women are women? Terrorist. Terroristas, I believe, is the Spanish way of saying it. So mom and apple pie will get you in Gitmo. Being for standard prosperity, standard what works, proven, is evil. Being good is evil. So they're making the segue. I was the first to tell you about how they'd roll out white Al-Qaeda. I was the first to tell you they were going to mesh it with the military, veterans. I was the first to give you the documents. People couldn't believe it. Folks, I know the enemy. I'm not bragging. I'm saying you need to listen to me. This is a real foreign collaborator occupation. Those are not words. That is not rhetoric. That is real. So obviously, we're going to talk about this because the story broke after I got off the air Friday, kind of got buried over the weekend. Drudge wisely at themightydrudgereport.com waited till Sunday night into Monday morning to put it up, knowing it's important and needs to get attention. This story is big, and it's not that long of a story, but it gives some background, and it ties into everything. So we're going to cover that, because here's the deal. If we cause a public debate about this, if we force a discussion about how the veterans are quietly being demonized and that a civil war is being prepared, like Emperor Palpatine wanting to wipe out the Jedi in Episode 3, I mean, that's literally what's being prepared. They use the military to set up the world government, believing that they're fighting tyranny worldwide. They set up the world government. Now they know the military won't go along with the final tyranny. They've got to have Order 66 executed on them. Execute Order number 66. Literally. And by the way, George Lucas said, and I'm using a popular cheesy, you know, movie as a way to illustrate this, he said at Cannes Film Festival when that came out in 99 or 2000, whatever it was, he said, no, it was 2001, that's when Episode 3 came out, that's right. He said, this is how the world really works. I wrote this to reflect what's currently happening. 9/11 had just happened, so I guess 99, 2001, 2003 is when it came out. We'll check the date. The point is, that's basically what's going on, and they're getting ready to have a civil war against the military. Stay with us. The globalists know that the people of the planet are waking up big time to how the corporate tyranny operates, how it wages war against the free market and true capitalism while masquerading as capitalism to discredit it. And they are making their move to fully gut the U.S. borders entirely and complete our journey into slavery with a giant voting block that is a lapdog to the establishment. Boehner's big reform decision is now upon us. We're going to be breaking that down. Republican and Democratic advocates see one final long shot chance to pass immigration reform this summer. And its fate rests with Speaker stuck between his party's resistance and his search for a career-defining legacy. That's what The Hill says, and that story's up at drudgereport.com. That's how they sell this. Boehner is a globalist. Boehner won't get rid of Obamacare. He says he'll try to tweak some of the bad parts of it. The whole thing is a monstrosity. Boehner plays golf with Obama. Boehner is bankrolled by the very same special interests. And I know you know that. And it's blue blood Republicans like him that have helped destroy this country. And again, I know I'm stating the obvious. It's just that no other country in the world can you go there and have a baby and have it paid for by the state. Nowhere in the world can you be a foreigner and come to the country and get free tuition or in-state tuition. There is a giant magnet to bring poor, unskilled immigrants here to drive down wages and politically balkanize and break up the country. The globalists get rid of nations, putting them into larger super states, and then break the super states up along non-continuous sub-region lines. That is the management system of the Romans, and then later the Venetians, who then basically moved operations to what is now the UK. And they've all written books on the subject, going back to Machiavelli 500 years ago. This is public history for anyone who is informed. I don't know about NFL football. I don't know about the latest Dancing with the Stars information. I do know about contract law. I do know about admiralty law. I do know about military history. I do know about political systems and how things really work. Not how we're told they work, but how they really work. And it doesn't mean I'm a master of this knowledge. Because as you approach becoming what you would think of being a master, you discover that you're always actually a student, and the world, the universe, is the teacher. God is the master. And this country is going to be taught and bent over the knee of the universe, and this planet is, and is going to go through some extreme pain because we are repeating history in the worst of ways. Twisted with it is a high-tech system of technocratic malice and anti-human viciousness that is unrivaled in the annals of known history on this terra firma, on this orbiting planetoid in deep space off the arm of the Milky Way galaxy in our star system. Just like to point that out, where we are right now, and remember that TV and movie stars and people showing off and acting cool is the Matrix. And that realizing you're in the universe and the universal time flow of the space-time continuum is to exist, is to be conscious. And to realize in a Zen way that fully incorporates into my Christian beliefs that we are a moment in forever that is forever. Think about how incredible that is, that you ever had consciousness and ever had a thought and could ever create is the fulcrum of life itself and of conscious, sentient being. It hit me so hard last night as I was laying down to go to bed and I tucked my children to sleep that art and beauty and virtue, and I know I'm stating the obvious, but it hit me so hard, is the answer to evil. If we will just be loving, if we will just be virtuous, if we will just be honorable, if we will just be strong, if we will just not be cowards, if we will believe in others as well and believe that they can be good and believe that they can be honorable, we will find each other in this world and we will come together, kindred spirits, and build a better world. We have to love each other, and we have to care about the innocent, but we also have to have the will, because you can go too far, and submit to corruption and evil. Truly good people have to stand against evil. And even though we don't want the power, even though we don't desire the stage, we must take the stage or be supplanted and blown out the airlock of history by the enemy. PLA troops are descending on China-Vietnam border. Looks like China could basically invade. There's all sorts of confrontations going on in the ocean, at oil rigs. I'm going to be breaking that down. It's huge. Quote, a lot more terror attacks are coming our way, says former NSA chief as they hype fear ahead of the total police state takeover. Kerry tells Yale grads to keep faith in government. Every time I see one of these speeches, Obama or Hillary or Kerry or Michelle Obama gives a speech, it's keep the faith. It's like a Baptist church or a Catholic church going, keep the faith, brethren. Believe in God. God will not forsake you. But this is literally keep the faith in the state. Keep the faith. We only need a few good men to keep the faith. This is really sick. You can debate the existence of God all day, but let me tell you something. There's no debating that 9 times out of 10, the state ends up delivering nightmare systems, broken systems. But in most cases, when it delivers a nightmare, it's on purpose. It's not broken. It's not on accident. Venezuela is broken. Cuba is broken. North Korea is broken. Communist China and the United States, run by the globalists, are not broken. They're working just like they're supposed to, dehumanizing. So all that and more is coming up. We have the niece of Dr. Martin Luther King joining us to talk about the culture of death and how the black communities have been tested and targeted as the beta test for virtual annihilation. And if you don't believe 52% of blacks never getting out of mama's womb isn't a mass genocide, I don't know what is. And for me, that's the litmus test of all these people shooting their mouths off, that if you don't like socialist death panels and Obamacare, you're a racist. Or if you don't turn your guns in, you're a racist. All of this is a total desperate, panicked move to create racial division and race war in this country because the globalists are on their heels right now and are running around like foaming at the mouth psychopaths trying to destroy everything they can and blow up the country politically and financially and culturally and spiritually before it all goes down. That's their exit strategy of scorched earth. Now, I want to move into our top story. This broke in the worst possible time to break on a Friday afternoon at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com, DrudgeReport.com, Wisely, the aggregating super giant media system, and published it Sunday night, which I found is the best time to put an article out to have it be a big story on Monday. That's now happened. Center column, DrudgeReport.com. You can see the headline, Police Now Armed for War Against Returning Veterans. Cops in armored vehicles asked by residents, are you coming to take our guns away? That's in the 5.5-minute clip from Fox 59. Now, I know I've harped on this a lot, shown you documents, stories, video of urban warfare training, army times, you name it. They admit, yeah, our number one threat's returning veterans, gun owners, libertarians, conservatives. But when you see the police getting the armored vehicles from Iraq and Afghanistan and admitting that the main enemy is veterans, and every police department, I learned about this 6 years ago, was told, I was actually sent documents by state police, federal marshals, cops, all the same document, just different local headers. We published them, they were national news. Where they said, you will be attacked by veterans with IEDs in the coming years. Not, we think, or it could be, you will. And I'm like, this is going to be a civil war. They're going to stage terror attacks around the country. The globalists are. They're going to come after veterans in a purge. The veterans will be forced to fight back, and that'll be the civil war, meant to kill the police and military, killing their former brethren. Tonight of the Long Knives, execute order number 66, the 2005 Revenge of the Sith. I mean, this is how you do it. Children's movies have this plot. It's very easy to understand. We've got Marine Corps colonels going public, Homeland Security building domestic army to take on the American people. That's highly decorated Marine Corps colonel who broke that down That was back in last year. We'll scroll down. I'll give folks his name. Colonel Peter Martino in the city council. We were still trying to get him on. Can't find his number. Somebody knows him. Get him on with us. This is the reality. They're pre-deploying. They're preparing. This is for us. This is treason. That's what he said. This is like if the Mexican military massed 100,000 troops on the U.S. border and then showed training of them trying to take us on, people would say, wow, Mexico's planning to attack the U.S. Or a better analogy would be like, as it's a bigger army, Hitler massing on the Polish border in 1939. I mean, it's absolute hair on the back of my neck standing up when I talk about it. Just 24/7 training for war. And then I know how they're going to initiate it. I know what's going to happen. We're sitting here seeing the whole deal unfold. If we don't cause a debate about this, they're going to be able to execute it. We've got a chance to stop the execution of their main battle plan. We know their attack profile. We have the enemy documents. We have got to warn people about the collaborators. We'll be back with the clips.
When I first started, we really didn't have the violence that we see today. The weaponry is totally different now than it was in the beginning of my career. Plus, you have a lot of people that are coming out of the military that have the ability and the knowledge to build IEDs and to defeat law enforcement.
Okay, let's stop right there. Everything that Indiana SWAT team commander in Morgan County just said is a lie. We weren't seeing the violence before that we're seeing now. The violent crime rate is down 52% since 1992, the Justice Department's own numbers. And those are very accurate numbers because they're compiled off of homicides and stabbings and shooting, and they're amongst, with statisticians worldwide, amongst the best in the world. The FBI's been doing it since the 20s, when J. Edgar Hoover started it. The violent crime rate. Folks, I don't need to believe the statistics. I grew up in Dallas in the 80s, where there would be 20 people dead some days in the summer. I grew up visiting family in downtown Dallas for church in a middle-class area and hearing gunshots. When I was a little kid and went to D.C. for the first time, when I was about 8, we had a balcony in our hotel and went outside and heard shots. And then heard shots the next night. The crime peak in this country was in the 1980s. But again, this is a total rollout with no troops planting IEDs, none of that happening. The only event was Timothy McVeigh, 1995, total government operation. We know who did it, the names of the people from police officers they weren't able to kill. They did kill some of them. Doctors and police officers, Terrence Yakey and others that saw the feds. The other cops and people that worked there spoke out before they could be killed. Don Browning, head of the K-9 unit. I'm naming names. Oklahoma City PD. He's told by the FBI, you keep talking, we're going to kill you and your wife. He's been on this show, video Skype. Jane Graham, HUD, saw the feds planting the bombs and said, what are you doing? Oh, we're working on the phone system. Because she would use the access stairs for exercise. Oh, she saw McVeigh with known FBI agents who she saw in the news later. You understand that? We know who blew the building up. I'm risking my life even bringing this up, but I don't care. The truth is what matters. I'm not backing down. So they got one event to claim all the veterans are going to kill everybody because one vet did something. Really, if a guy with red hair goes out and kills people, are all redhead suspects? Or if a black person kills somebody, are all black people suspect? Or if a woman kills somebody? Or if a Catholic? Or if a Buddhist kills somebody? Or I am sick of this authoritarianism where you're all guilty because someone else did something. Veterans statistically have some of the lowest crime rates out there, and everybody knows that. They do have a higher tendency for mass shootings, but it's still extremely low. Mass shootings only kill 167 people in 2013. More than half of them were gangs shooting each other. Honeybees killed almost 300. Look it up. But we're going to play pretty much the whole newscast, and I want to talk about it and get into all the other news. But this article is up on Infowars.com. Police departments everywhere are getting DHS training in the last 6 years, and they tell them, look it up in the training manuals that are online, it's not a question of if, but when, you will be hit. You will be hit. The veterans are going to kill you. Now, I'm going to say this. 10 years before Vietnam, on record, they were doing jungle training for Southeast Asia because they could tell the Indo-French were going to get thrown out. They were out by 1960. The U.S. was really there from 60 to 64 covertly. 5,000 troops died, we know of. Then 58,000 died after that up until 1975 when they officially started the whole thing with the Gulf of Tonkin false flag. They start these with false flags. It's declassified. Gulf of Tonkin to get us into Vietnam was staged. And ladies and gentlemen, more than a decade before they got ready for the Desert Storm and all that, they were already getting ready to set up Saddam by telling him to invade Kuwait and the rest of it, and the Iran-Iraq War. They were getting ready for Desert War. And now, for a decade, it happened under Bush, but it's accelerated under Obama, they are now preparing for war with who? Gun owners, veterans, pro-lifers, libertarians, Americans, good people. And so we're here covering this to force a debate about it. Because if there's a debate about this, they're not going to be able to do it. But it will be, they will stage a false flag, and then that will be preceded by the, quote, civil war. They're going to blow up schools, you name it, blame them on the liberty movement. Then they're going to come after us in a purge. Then a real civil war is going to start. I think it'll kill probably 300,000 police. What you're hearing, ladies and gentlemen, is not a radio show. It's not a television simulcast. It is real. It's an emergency transmission worldwide. We've decoded the enemy's operation. It's public. They're moving against us in plain view. We know their goals. We know their ideology. They are alien. They are foreign. They will mean the destruction of all we hold dear. Due process, our families, and basic justice. We're in a stance right now of partial awakening and awareness. We have a chance if we simply awaken our brethren to defeat the globalist across the board. We've held them back. They're at least a decade behind in their own globalist documents by Brzezinski, Kissinger, and others. They're trying to accelerate their program right now and finish it. And they're now operating in a race to the finish line because they realize if they fail, they're going down 100%. Even though they have a low probability of succeeding, even midterm, they are now racing because it's the only chance they've got. And you can see the massive preparation for false flag terror attacks that are staged in this country to be blamed on the liberty movement to then launch a purge against the resistance, against the counter-revolutionaries. That's you and I. Once that launches, the plan is to have the liberty movement wipe out the military and police and vice versa. This is what the globalists want. Do you understand that, ladies and gentlemen? We cannot let it get to this. We've got to stop this program. We stopped the open arming and bombing for Al-Qaeda in Syria. We stopped the public turnover of Egypt to Al-Qaeda. We have been stopping a lot of their operations, not just us here in America, but others worldwide that understand what's happening. Truth is the disinfectant. The enemy will not move unless they think they can get away with it. And I want the globalists to know, your own people who compartmentalized listen to this show because they recognize what we talk about here is true as prima facie or on its face because they're there every day seeing what I'm talking about going on internally. They know I know what I'm talking about. The Navy SEALs, the Army Special Forces, the CIA people, the defense intelligence people, the defense contractors, the lawyers, the judges, the bureaucrats, the FBI, the federal marshals, the Secret Service. Most of these people are good men and women who actually got into their jobs for the right reasons. And you've been operating under compartmentalization. I'm here to blow the compartments. The compartments are good to fight an outside enemy in a time of war. The compartments are bringing the nation down, allowing the disease to quietly spread house to house, building to building, facility to facility. We have got to decompartmentalize this whole operation right now and blow this operation right now. The globalists are the most unmitigatedly sickening, wicked, evil, warmongering, anti-human pieces of unspeakable filth, to the point of words cannot describe the pit of hell stench that emanates from them spiritually. If you have any common sense, any life force, any will to survive, any will to thrive, any will for justice, any will for light, you should set your full will against the enemy. And I'm telling you, if you just set your will against evil and ask for God's guidance, even if you don't believe in God, you have to ask God into your heart and you have to give permission. You have to make a decision and just say, I recognize darkness from light. I recognize good from bad. I want to be good. To quote Judge Smales from Caddyshack, do you want to be good, Danny? I want to be good, sir. Good, Danny. Very good. And we can make jokes about that all day. Judge Smales is a globalist who acts like he's good, but he's a hypocrite and a crook. And that's what that's all about. We will lose everything, ladies and gentlemen. In fact, I love that new promo piece that an activist I've seen for more than a decade on the streets of Austin with InfoWars signs and anti-fluoride signs, Scottish John cut. Buckley, will you get that loaded in the computer so I can play that before we go to break? I'd like to play Scottish John because I think he says it all. I told him and Jacobson, just cut whatever ad you guys come up with, and they came up with a much better promo than I would come up with. He says in that great Scottish accent, we better get involved now or we're going to lose everything. And everybody knows in their gut, we're going to lose everything. The military has been training the police so the police can then train to take on the military. And you have the hypothetical argument that, well, the military could turn against us and is going to. That's a self-fulfilling prophecy. You could say the police are going to turn on us. They have all this training. And you know what? They are in the big departments because they're under Homeland Security, ladies and gentlemen. Local SWAT teams in big cities are already under Homeland Security for, quote, special events. You're going to aid the Secret Service when the president's here. And then it expands out to everything else being infrastructure protection to where your local police have been internationalized, not just federalized. But I want to play this clip from the story up at drudgereport.com in the middle column. Police now armed for war against returning veterans. And again, in the training manuals that we published that are in the article, I'm going to have Watson add some of our previous stories in this because the story's getting a lot of attention. They say it's not a question of if but when we're going to have this war with the veterans. And then you learn the Marines, the Army, all of them, that's the main mission. And what was it, 3 years ago, responding to one of our articles that was on Drudge, Big Sis came out and said, we don't apologize. It was an AP. We don't apologize. The headline was DHS head stands behind controversial report labeling veterans number one threat. I'm going to explain this again. They're openly saying veterans are the number one terror threat when all the statistics say the opposite. And then the globalists are the ones running Al-Qaeda, launching chemical attacks, blaming it on Syria, getting caught trying to attack military bases in Egypt to overthrow the government. Our government is so criminal, folks, it publicly funds Al-Qaeda now, like you're so stupid, you won't figure that out. Well, you know what? Litmus test. Ted Cruz, Rand Paul, both get up and say, our government runs Al-Qaeda now. It's evil. We shouldn't be part of it. What happens? They can't launch the full attack. They have to back off because they told the truth. All you do is, did Ted Cruz and Rand Paul get discredited for saying our government runs Al-Qaeda? No, they got carried on people's shoulders because the military already knew it and didn't want to be part of it. Well, that sounds crazy that our government runs Al-Qaeda, but it's true. My grandmother a few years ago, I grew up knowing this guy lived down the street. He was a guy with really bad arthritis and a wheelchair, and some neighbor got in his face, and slapped him around or something. So the next day he came out with a gun and shot him. And it's just, oh, you know, where's such and such? Oh, he's in prison now. You know, he shot and killed the neighbor. It just happened. Well, it's kind of like, well, our government just runs Al-Qaeda. Or, oh, they just found dead bodies in Bob's backyard. Yes, it's crazy, but it's going on. So let's go ahead and play the head of the SWAT team in Morgan County, Indiana, Sergeant Dan Downing, saying, we're going to be patrolling the streets, getting everybody acclimated. I see these trucks all the time in Austin. DHS has them. You know, to Arde Saveda's credit, he says, Austin doesn't need any of those. Well, you've got some other smaller ones. But DHS has got them here in town. I see them driving around. Those are meant to go to your house and burn your house down. They're meant to go and dig people out, folks. They're not meant when you go on the defense if you actually got attacked. I mean, why not give Abrams tanks? You know, the military knows how to drive one. Why, a bunch of veterans can go to an armory and take it over and get tanks. We better get rid of the armories. See, they're saying we can't trust each other. Watch everyone. Homeland Security's for the veterans. The one group they know, just like Smedley Butler, who's going to stand up to a domestic takeover and say no. They have analyzed where the threat comes. New alternative media, Infowars.com, WorldNet Daily, DrudgeReport.com, things like that, openly demonized by the globalists. Talk radio, they don't control. They want to shut that down. The free internet, state government, the John Warner Defense Authorization Act, says they're training to take on the American people and to, quote, take over governorships and legislatures. The feds are openly saying, we're prepared to take over your states and take over your city councils, and we're going to run things. They're prepared for the feds to give orders so evil that the American people that'll put up with anything are going to stand up and say no, and our state houses are going to say no. And what are they going to say no to? Total military occupation, gun confiscation. They know there's already county commissioners and mayors in multiple places in, what was it, in Lubbock last year? Saying, you know, the county judge, the county mayor, said, we know they're planning gun confiscation. They're gonna come down the road in armored vehicles. We've got to prepare for war. And why did he know that? Because DHS had come into Lubbock. We talked to his office. He said he would come on, but never did. But we talked to his chief of staff, and they said, no, the judge knows this because we got visited by DHS with the takeover plan. And I said, they've got to come on the air and tell this story. Well, you know, he may come on, Mr. Jones. He knows who you are. I mean, folks, they're coming in to the cities and the counties saying, are you prepared for war? And a lot of the police are going, okay, yeah, yes, sir. Salute the flag, salute Obama, as they prepare for a total takeover. Do you understand what's happening here? Treason. There's no debating. This is Vichy French. Guys, will you print me the Wikipedia, Vichy French? I want to read that to folks. The Vichy French, the French, folks, fought the Germans in World War I with the U.S. and England and beat them. The French used to be very militaristic. Their people finally woke up and said no to it. But the Vichy French, over 90% of the general staff of the French military were Nazi sympathizers, and they stood down at the Maginot Line, and then the British Expeditionary Force was forced to Dunkirk and had to evacuate. They stood down. The French stood down and were given power, the French military, over France. That's how 3 days after the invasion, Hitler was able to come visit Paris, and the police were on his side and held the crowds back. They arrested hundreds of thousands of people. The analogy, and I'm begging media, even mainstream, if you love your kids out there, you know who you are. You better write about this, folks, or we're going to lose everything. And at least my testament's here warning people up front. The Vichy French model, folks, how do you think they took down Saddam the first time, bought off most of his generals? The second time in 1993, they bought them almost all off. There was almost a complete stand down, except for a few units loyal to Saddam in Baghdad. Then Iranians came in, along with Saudi Arabian proxy armies, and began battling each other for control of the country, Shiite versus Sunni, and only when U.S. or coalition forces got in between them did they get killed. It's on record they bought them all off. This is how they did it, folks. They bought them off. Delta Force in the 90s was buying off county commissioners and mayors and police chiefs. And we knew because Thomas Sanchez, the head of emergency management in Kingsville, came on my show and said that they offered, he was a Vietnam vet, Army intelligence, to pay him off to go along with gun confiscation. It was a test. It was going on in every county in the country. Then they went to the police chief of San Antonio, tried to buy him off with $200,000 in a briefcase. Delta Force. I went to the Travis County and Austin SWAT teams. They laughed at me. 6 months later, Lieutenant Beck called me and said, please come to my office. He goes, Delta Force was here. It's all true. My God, what's going on? He was fired a month later. Made up, you know, racism BS. No, he was fired because of the Delta Force situation. He thought he laughed at me in his office. He said, I'm a Marine Corps veteran in Vietnam. We're not trying to take on America. That'll never happen. I said, all right, well, they'll be here soon. He literally laughed at me. He didn't laugh later. He didn't laugh when they fired him. Nope, I'm sure he might be still alive. Last time I heard, he was a security guy at the Austin airport. This isn't a game, ladies and gentlemen. I've had military attack me in a parking lot telling me to shut up. And they gained a lot of respect for me when I beat the hell out of them. And they beat me up pretty bad as well. But the whole point is that I'm not shutting up or backing down. I know how real all this is. They got military crawling all over us, folks, that are ready to carry out this treasonous activity. And they're going to hunt veterans down. If you were in special forces and ran serious operations and you haven't joined them or you haven't been given an offer to join them, you're on a kill list. I'm sure you already know that. So just be ready. We're not going to be caught flat-footed when the New World Order makes this move if they do. We're hoping to stop it, but if we don't stop it, we're going to win against the Vichy French. We're going to put up a lot bigger fight than the French Resistance did in the first few years. And I'm just an information person, organically here warning you. If this all goes hot, folks, that'll be the end of me. Even if they don't kill me, I won't be on air. You won't hear from Alex Jones again, probably. My time could be coming to an end. Everybody needs to understand that. Your time, this country's time, is coming to an end. But just remember, I was here and I warned you as much as I could. We may be able to back them off and stop them and get a reprieve. Then we'll be, oh, you said this is all going to happen as we hold the gates up from the main onslaught. Now, let's go ahead and go to this clip again from Fox News with the police saying they're preparing for war with the veterans. Here it is.
When I first started, we really didn't have the violence that we see today. The weaponry is totally different now than it was in the beginning of my career. Plus, you have a lot of people that are coming out of the military that have the ability and the knowledge to build IEDs and to defeat law enforcement.
We've always had that. Most of the cops are military. Mello, they got dossiers on all the cops, too. Let's go out to break with this Scottish John promo that he and Jacobson put together. I think it says it all.
This is Scottish John for Infowars.com. I know that most of you here in this commercial already know about the New World Order, eugenics, and all the other issues covered here at Infowars. The question is, do your friends and family know? If not, then I want to know why. Oh, I know it's tough to talk about this with some people. They might call you names, or they just want to talk about sports or soap operas. I say, so what? There's a battle going on out there right now. The ammunition is information, and the soldiers are you. It's time to transform your game from passive listener to active participant. We from Scotland have had our skin in this game for the greater part of the last 1,000 years, and I'm still fighting. If we don't all stand up right now, we're going to lose everything. The InfoWar is worldwide. Tell your friends about InfoWars and let them know that InfoWars doesn't print bull. It's real journalism and news backed up by documented fact. Step up and take your friends and family to InfoWars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv and PlanetInfoWars.com. The truth will set them free. This is Scottish John.
And again, folks, what did Matt Drudge say a few months ago? Everybody should have an exit plan out of the U.S. unless you're planning to fight. We'll be back. They always say, oh, in 30 years, there'll be brain chips to control prisoners' minds and make them behave. CBS News. Then 5 years later, they come out and go, oh, we're looking to put brain chips in prisoners' brains. Or, oh, in 30 years, we'll have brain chips for troops. Oh, actually, they're coming out in 2 years. And then now they're out. Here is a Yahoo News Reuters story. Cars could drive themselves sooner than expected after European push. Oh, the Google and others are lobbying and getting it legalized in all 50 states, and now they're on the streets everywhere. And, oh, the statistics are showing the driverless cars are safer maybe you need to pay extra insurance if you drive yourself. And then finally, no one can pay the insurance. No one's allowed to drive anymore except on special tracks. That's the plan to get you out of the cars. It's always been. They're 30 years more advanced in most cases than they tell us. This is a total takeover plan. They already have surveillance systems in all the cop cars, the cabs. Everybody's getting trained. The kids are being trained to live under this. We're going to get into that, but the EU pushing it. Satellite tracker boxes and all the new cars, taxing by the miles. It's here. It ain't coming. It's here. And again, the one area I can really focus on and really try to stop things is that what is the DHS doing openly training the police that they will fight veterans and conservatives and libertarians? This is a political takeover. Police should be just outraged. I know a lot of them are. But they're now mainlining these psyops for all over the country. They're going, yeah, we are training. We expect the veterans to attack any moment. They've always, in the last few years, had death panels for vets and people. Why are they hyping that up right now? Are they going to blow something up and say, the vets got mad because they didn't get health care, and so now don't trust vets? It's all about discriminating against vets. While they say, we love the vets, launch wars for the vets, you know, support Homeland Security for the vets, the police state, you know, support vets. They love the police state. Meanwhile, behind the scenes, they are obsessed with coming after vets. And I'll tell you why more than ever. Their prediction that the veterans would resist them politically is correct. Because I talk to the vets, but I mainly talk to active duty. They are so awake, it's incredible. Because they hear this show and it all clicks, if it hadn't already clicked. They know I'm telling the truth. They're dialed in like that. Snap of fingers. And they're not cowards. And they realize how short life is. And they're sick of all these political scum trying to ruin this country and ruin their lives, and they're tired of it. And they are the people that are going to end up standing in the way, and those of us that help them. Just like a military can be used to take over a country, it can also be used to save a country. Just like America's being used to overthrow the world, America can be used to save the world. That's the way it works. Briefly, we need your support now more than ever to send out these emergency transmissions. Buy the books, the videos, the pro-gun t-shirts. InfoWarsStore.com. InfoWarsLife.com has the best supplements out there with big discounts. The Supermill Vitality, the Survival Shield proprietary Nation Iodine. The sale is still going. The Lung Cleanse, the high-quality coffee. Even though coffee prices have gone up because of the fungus spreading everywhere, we still have it at low prices. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com, or call toll-free, shop with the good guys. It's basically like a donation when you buy high-quality products from us. Helps fund the operation. 888-253-3139. 888-253-3139. And you can also support our sponsors like MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex. Organic, high quality, great customer service, full line of preparedness items. MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex. You're nuts, folks, if you don't get high quality storable foods in a crazy world like this. And by being ready and prepared, the globalists may back off. We hope none of this ever happens. But I'm telling you, they're lining up to do it. So we better get involved right now. Next hour coming up. Stay with us. Martin Luther King's niece
Thank
is coming
you for
up.
Listening to GCN.
Your calls and a lot
Visit
more.
GCN.
I got a bunch of other news I want to intersperse in this hour, but I want to hear from veterans and active duty only who got good phones. I want to hear from you right now. What do you think of the police departments everywhere publicly training that you're terrorists and that they will have a war with you? I mean, this isn't even 2 + 2 = 4. This is just 1 + 1 = 2. This is open treason being prepared for. How do you think we stop it? How do we get this information out? The story's red linked up at InfoWars.com. Police now arming for against returning veterans, and it just says it all. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. You get our articles, our police state films. You give them to local police departments and sheriff's departments. If you golf with the local, you know, police chief or the cops, talk to them. Get them off their little, you know, power trip that they're the good guys and, you know, the feds are good and all this. They need to wake up and see the wider picture. Just because they're good guys and actually aren't corrupt doesn't mean they're not being given a corrupt mission in the future, and that the preparation for treason isn't there like a foreign army lining up on your border. Toll-free number for veterans and active duty. I want to hear from you. You won't have to hold long. I'm going to go to you quickly. 800-259-9231. And that's it. 800-259-9231. John Bowne just walked in here during the break. And he said, one of the producers, he said, is it just me or is Kerry and Holder both pushing for World War III? Yeah, they're both just constantly pushing for war with Russia. You've got tanks and armored vehicles and helicopters attacking the Russian-held areas that have always been Russian. And again, I'm not romanticizing the Russians. That's the word. I'm not romanticizing it. The West is starting this. George Soros is generaling or captaining the whole thing. I mean, it's just, it's Twilight Zone level. It's Twilight Zone level. They have used the openness of our society to bring in this garbage. Here's a headline up on Drudge. GOP takes on Michelle O's lunch rules. Yeah, my kids were going to private school a couple years ago. They homeschool fully now. And it was a good school, but to be accredited, it was like handouts from Michelle Obama every few months and like telling the kids what was good to eat. It was like horrible GMO Lunchables and stuff. House Republicans are proposing to let schools opt out of healthier school lunch. I mean, it's like prison food now. It's worse than food I've had in jail the times I've been arrested as a protester. Never convicted me. I mean, I've been quite a few times in the Hooskow for stuff. And I was in juvenile a couple times because there'd be a big fight. And, you know, somebody goes to the hospital, they take you to jail regardless, and you're in there over the weekend. And, you know, I mean, it was prison food is better than what they feed in the schools. Why not? Parents put up with it, and now they're saying parents can't bring the lunches under DHS, under Michelle, Health and Human Services. You know what? In Denver and Chicago, the school districts are saying, parents, you can't be trusted. Oh, they use allergies. You might put peanuts in so you can't be trusted. Yeah, because we're so sickly now from GMO that it triggers people's allergies. So kids are like invalids now. Pretty soon, half the kids will be dying. Pediatric cancer is already up over 10,000% on average. Look it up. And the answer will be, we have GMO patties for your kid. You can't pack a lunch for your prisoner. Hell, even in most prisons, they let family bring you food when they visit. Not anymore. Maximum security for our children, ladies and gentlemen, with select insider groups. In fact, I remember we showed some photos a while back of, if you just type in Michelle school food prisoners, and it'll show it next to prisoner food and then shots of it. It's unbelievable. All right, your calls coming up. I'd like to hear from some police, too. I mean, I know you're all training that the vets are going to kill you any minute. And I guess when they blow stuff up and blame it on the vets and try to arrest a bunch of them, the vets will fight back. They won't go to the FEMA camp, and it'll be self-fulfilled. Look, they're terrorists. So I guess we're just too stupid to stop this civil war. I guess that's what people want. People hate the vets so much they want war with them. All right, I just spent a lot of the first hour interspersing other important news, but covering police now armed for war against returning veterans. And I've been harping on this on Sunday's show and now today. And we're live broadcasting worldwide on the 19th day of May 2014. Coming up at the bottom of the hour, she's just with us for 10 minutes. We'll continue back to calls. The niece of Dr. Martin Luther King, Alveda King, is coming on to talk about abortion genocide in this country and what's really happening. She's with Press for Life, so she's going to be joining us. We appreciate her joining us today. But let me just play part of the newscast, where in the newscast, it's a 5.5-minute newscast up on Infowars.com and DrudgeReport.com, also has it linked in the middle column, that, oh, we got to have these giant wheeled tanks because the veterans are coming home. We've always had veterans coming home and didn't need tanks rolling around in small towns. Here it is.
They're your tax dollars at work, and instead of being blown up, scrapped, or given away to a foreign country, surplus U.S. military hardware is coming home from the war.
Hit pause. Let's start from the beginning again. Why not nerve gas then? I mean, we've got hundreds of thousands of gallons at bases, and we're probably millions of gallons total of nerve gas, VX and sarin. Well, why doesn't the Pentagon spray that on America? I mean, we don't want to waste it. And I said this going back a decade ago when they were buying these armored vehicles and right through to an order just a few years ago for thousands more. They're making them, they're manufacturing them, and they're just rolling around now. You'll come to a checkpoint and the cops will have one while they're searching cars with a machine gun on your car. It's all training us to be an occupied country. This is the rollout. And all over the country, they have military drills that then go live with the Marines and the Army. Remember East St. Louis last year? Where they said, no, this is martial law? And this has been going on for a long time, but it's building up and accelerating. Let's go back to the newscast.
They're your tax dollars at work, and instead of being blown up, scrapped, or given away to a foreign country, surplus U.S. military hardware is coming home from the wars and being assigned to the streets and back roads of central Indiana to keep Hoosiers safe.
Oh.
Time of escalating homeland violence.
Hey, pause. Now, this is all scripted. If I had to bet, it was written by Homeland Security Justice Department. Maybe Southern Poverty Law Center. They keep saying, in a time of escalating violence, in a time of escalating crime, and the cop later says, the head of the SWAT team, because, you know, of all this horrible violence, the veterans, none of that's true. But, and then they roll out the old 70s SWAT show when they popularize everybody's got to have a SWAT team. This is how they program the public. Let's go back to it. Yeah, just kill everybody.
They got one in Martinsville, an excess U.S. Army mine-resistant vehicle, an MRAP, cast off by the American military and parked at the Morgan County Sheriff's Department.
The value of the vehicle was $650,000. It didn't cost us any money at all.
Hit pause. They sell it like they're getting something free. This is all a psyop. I've seen literally over the years hundreds of newscasts like this. They've had Marines, Army, you name it, at the checkpoints as well. This is such treason. I'm going to your phone calls in a moment. You know what? The full newscast is up at Infowars.com as we analyze this treason. But let's play the clip of the SWAT team commander who gets to be a military guy and feel like he's a vet while he drives around in the rural area looking for meth labs. I mean, this is a total joke, folks. The government brings in most of the narcotics. Let's go ahead and play the clip of him saying, for the veterans.
When I first started, we really didn't have the violence that we see today. The weaponry is totally different now than it was in the beginning of my career. Plus, you have a lot of people that are coming out of the military that have the ability and the knowledge to build IEDs and to defeat law enforcement.
And he goes on in the full clip. In fact, after we go to your calls, I'm going to play the full clip. Because in the full clip, he says, quote, He goes on to say, quote, we don't want to be outgunned by the veterans. He goes on to say, we were actually approached and asked why we have this. I'm going to put the full interview coming up, but I want to go to your calls. Again, this isn't just in this county. They ordered more than 10,000 extra of these in the last 5-6 years. Before that, in the last decade, they had a bunch of other ones. And they're deploying them everywhere and telling them. Because, folks, I have family that's involved in it, okay? I mean, I knew about this a decade ago. But now it's coming to an head. They're getting ready for something. And it doesn't mean we can't back it down. But they are training to take on mom and apple pie. John Wayne is the enemy. John Deere tractor is the enemy. Your granddaddy's the enemy. They train literally in zombie repulsion attacks. Here's Christian Science Monitor. No prank. On Halloween, U.S. military forces train for zombie apocalypse. And they practice mowing down men, women, and children dressed in rural clothing. We caught video of this previously at Urban Warrior deployments. Those are in my police state films. And so now they go, oh, it's just for zombies. When they practice mowing down crowds of people. That's the cover for it. This is total treason. Mike, Jason, Ernie, Adam, John, we're going to get to all of you right now. Ernie in Tennessee, what is your breakdown on this? They're getting pretty bold. We know it was going on secretly. This shows me they're thinking about going operational.
Yeah, I've got to agree with you, Alex. It looks like they're just finally coming out with it. They're just admitting it. And I really hope these police officers wake up.
Well, you're supposed to just lay down and let them take you to a re-education center. I mean, and I guess you're going to let them take your wives and kids off. I mean, do the cops really think people aren't going to fight?
Yeah, I don't know. You know, veterans outnumber the police. How many to one? 100 to one? I don't know. I don't want this to happen. I know you don't want this to happen, but what are you going to do if it does happen? I'm not going to stand by and let them destroy my country. They're destroying the future of my children and my grandchildren, Alex.
Well, here's the deal. There's going to be a lot of bad stuff that happens on both sides. That's war. If this goes down, and there's going to be problems, and they're going to stage atrocities and blame it on the Liberty Movement to try to win the PSYOP. But the vets know it's a PSYOP and aren't going to stop. This is only going to get worse once it starts. And again, there's no veterans doing anything right now. No IEDs, no cops being targeted. They are literally getting the police to pick a fight with veterans. I mean, I think the police are smart enough to understand the globalists hate their guts and want us to kill each other. I mean, don't they understand that?
Well, you know, I would like to think that, but to be honest with you, Alex, most of my friends, most of my inner circle are retired military. I live 30 minutes north of a very large Navy base in Millington, Tennessee, and my veteran friends are starting to wake up to actually what's going on. They've served. They've seen this. But on the other side of the coin, I know a lot of police just from my profession, and most of them do not have a clue and do not want a clue. They just don't want to hear about it.
Well, Civil War starts, they're going to get a clue real quick.
I believe so. Again, I pray it doesn't happen, but, man, they sure are pushing for it.
Well, just know that when they nuke a major city or blow up a school and say we did it, you know, I warned everybody. I really appreciate you. God bless. Adam, in West Virginia, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yes, sir. I think it's absolutely terrible that the veterans are public enemy number one. And I got a letter from the VA offering to give free gun locks. So I don't know if this is a way of them gauging the level of resistance.
No, absolutely. You know, no. I mean, it's all part of that first contact, like something's wrong with you. Like, oh, maybe you shouldn't have a gun. It's terrible.
And I can scan and email that letter in, and then it has like another sheet here for like the Veterans Crisis Line, and then just the sheet to mail it in. It's got some gun safety.
Yeah, and now they're starting like and demanding if you want more VA quote services that you've already paid for in blood, sweat, and tears, you've got to go in and talk to a psychologist. And it's, quote, we want to find out who's going to go haywire. It's not veterans that are going haywire, folks. It's 15-year-old kids on Ritalin and drugs like that.
Would you like me to scan and email that into?
Yes, sir. And a brief description of what happened. Show tips, one word, show tips at Infowars.com. That's a big story, and we'd like to get that out.
All right, sir. I will do that. Thank you.
Thank you for your call. John in Maryland, you're on the air. Go ahead. Go ahead,
hello?
John. Yes, sir. Go ahead.
You think they're getting ready? I think they are too, because around Baltimore and D.C., they were at the intersections for the highways, like the beltways that go around Baltimore and D.C. in 95 and 83 hit. They were running electrical metal electrical conduit to the center, and now there's like electrical junction boxes.
Well, they're hardening facilities, putting in infrastructure, building their new private internet. I mean, it's a total takeover. It's literally, let me not exaggerate, 30 times bigger than the Manhattan Project. This secret police state project against America, this treason, this Vichy French takeover is just mega massive. And they've had it going in slow motion forever, but it finally hits a flashpoint. What does your gut tell you?
I don't know. When I was in the National Guard, they had the snipers dressing up with like Environmental Protection Agency coveralls on, and they broke down their rifles and put them in toolboxes, and they were going into the projects in like in between D.C. and Baltimore and like Prince George's County, and they were working with like the FBI and stuff. It was really, really, really uncomfortable, because I've been listening to you for like 6 years, and the first time I heard them say that, I was like, oh, man, you guys are playing with fire. You don't want to be doing that. Like,
God bless you, brother. We'll be right back with Mike, Jason, Max, Joe, and others. And I have the full clip coming up. Stay with us. So in this Fox News clip where they're talking about, you know, we need these armored vehicles for the veterans, which we've always had in this country, as they prepare to stage this new war, we're going to play that clip after some calls where he says, don't worry, we're not coming for your guns. Well, maybe this SWAT team guy isn't, but if he gets the orders, that will happen. And the globalists have taken the guns everywhere they're in control, and they admit that's their goal. And that's how they'll try to start a civil war. Let's go ahead and, I mean, you see the massive preparation for it. They're not doing this for nothing. Let's talk to Mike in California. What's your take on this?
Hey, Alex, love your show. We love your work. I've got quite a bit of insight, retired Marine, number of combat tours, graduated a police academy. So I got some insight on the mindset. Really, to tell you the truth, it's more paranoia on their part than anything. That cop up in L.A. that, what was his name? I can't even remember now.
Dorner.
That went off the rails. And, the guy was had some tactical training, not a whole lot, but he, you know, you could see from their response, they overreacted to everything the guy did. So the fact of the matter is, they know that launching any kind of an offensive against very highly tactically trained military at this point, returning veterans, is stupid. They're just paranoid. They're scared. They want to be prepared for guys like that L.A. cop. Now, having said that, we're not really worried about it. We're not concerned about it. If they come after us, we know it's a big mistake, and if we don't have guns, we'll just take theirs. They can't win. It's a fight that they can't win. You've said it numerous times. So we're just sitting here waiting. I'm just doing my job, going to work, and up, doing what I do every day. And if that's something they decide to do, we'll just say no. We're drawing the line. You're not doing it. And trust me, they'll back off. We're not just sitting here. The reason why they haven't had any big-scale problems with veterans is because we're not scared of them. We're not worried about them because they can't win.
I'll say this. We were just playing Sunday Pentagon clips with them admitting that nobody can defeat a low-tech group that refuses to surrender. That's why I say resistance is victory. I mean, if the globalists really try to start a civil war with the American people and gun owners, I mean, it's the only thing they have is a psyop to stage terror attacks and blame it on us, hoping that then the people turn against us. But that's not going to work because everybody knows they're staging the terror attacks. I mean, we have hammered that so hard that I don't see how they're going to get away with it. But I'm telling you, the globalists are emboldened. They are going ahead with it. I mean, they're not spending hundreds of billions of dollars the last 10 years training the police for war with gun owners and conservatives for no reason. And they intend to go ahead with this. They're going to stage a race war in the middle of it to really confuse things. And again, it doesn't make sense to you. You're saying, well, we'll kick their butt. Yeah, they want us. They want the American gun owner to take out the police and military forum. And so there's the master stroke. How do you stop that from happening?
Well, stop it from happening, we just fight them. For instance, when we go through a door somewhere, you shoot the first two or three Marines through the door, that doesn't mean they're stopping. We're still coming. They may take out a few, but we're not going to stop. The blood of our forefathers is still in us from this day. You just have to be around them. You have to be in active duty units in a combat situation to understand how well they adjust to changing situations on the battlefield, how determined they are. And even though there's always a little distraction on what our background is or where we come from, we always center back on to target and get back centered.
Well, so I will say we have the globalists in check if we use it. The fact that literally 80%+ of military that I run into that are active duty are listeners. That's got to really scare the establishment that the core listening audience of this show is veterans and active duty. Why do you think that is?
Because they on the inside and they see the truth, you awaken them, you start them doing their own research, you make them proactive rather than being reactive. And you have to understand that that's what brings us in the door to the recruiting office in the first place, is that mindset. You just give us a tool. You just give us the
exactly. I'm not doing anything. I'm saying America's being taken over. They're training for war against the American people. What are we going to do? And the veterans are saying, we're going to figure it out. And the globalists are scared, and they should be. I mean, we could arrest these globalists so quickly, try them, and really fix this country. It wouldn't be perfect, but it'd be a lot better than conscious evil trying to run this nation in the ground. God bless you. I appreciate your call. Jason, Max, Joe, Bruce, and many others, your calls are coming up. We have the niece of Martin Luther King, an amazing writer and speaker in her own right, joining us to talk about the silent genocide going on in this country. Stay with us. I'm Alex Jones, InfoWars.com. Well, I share that dream that we judge people on what they stand for and who they are, not what color they are, where they came from. And also have a dream that we not abort another 53 million, 54 million babies since Roe v. Wade, and that we not kill 52% of black people. And especially because that is a genocide going on for every black person that is aborted. You've only got half as many white or Hispanic. Blacks are being targeted, and Dr. Alveda C. King joins us. She's got a new book coming out, King's Rules. She's going to come back on with us for a longer interview in late June to get into her book that I look forward to reading. But in the 10 minutes we've got, thank you so much for coming on with us, Doctor.
I'm so grateful to join you and your listening audience. It's just a blessing.
Well, you've got 10 minutes. Let's get into the black genocide that's going on with abortion and where Dr. King would have stood on that and where all this is going and how we hopefully awaken America.
Well, we know here in the 21st century, it's been on for a long time, but it was more of a secret in the 20th century and the 19th century. During the time of slavery, when slavery was abolished in America, there became a big question of what to do with the former slaves. Because we as a people had been oppressed, not allowed to read, not to be well educated, and we were free labor for America. And so the abolitionists, after President Lincoln signed emancipation, the abolitionists would say that these are human beings and they should be treated fairly. And so there's been that ongoing struggle. You know the history of Jim Crow laws, you know the history of my uncle, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., the 20th century civil rights movement. Well, the eugenics movement, led by people like Margaret Sanger, who founded Planned Parenthood, she was an affiliate of Adolf Hitler, who created that horrible movement against the Jews, that Holocaust. So they were some patriarchs working together, and their plan was to reduce the Negro population, which is now the African-American population. And one of the plans included sterilization and what was called birth control, which today is shots and pills and things like Depo-Provera, the HHS mandate in America, saying that you have to give free birth control to the needy. And, of course, with the African-Americans being at the top of that list, to eliminate the birth of African-Americans. And when African-Americans do conceive, Planned Parenthood is as the leader, the largest abortion provider, is saying help them to abort those babies. So that's the short version of what eugenics and genocide has come to be in America. I work for Priests for Life, the director of African-American outreach, and it is my mission to educate Americans and really people around the globe that eugenics and genocide still exist in America in the 21st century.
Well, Obamacare funds abortion and tries to force churches to pay for it. And Obama's been a great poster child for increasing African, basically forced abortions in Africa where they won't let people onto their own land and thing unless they have abortions. In China, they have forced abortions inside the Foxconn factories. But as long as they dress it up as liberal, it's okay. As long as they say it's the Democratic Party, it's okay. Again, I don't romanticize the Republican Party, but the truth is they were the ones that created the NRA to arm newly freed black slaves to protect themselves from the Klan. It was the Republicans that helped get the Civil Rights Act passed. I don't get how the Democrats have flipped history on its head and call anybody who's against black genocide racist.
Well, that is really the quandary that we're having, calling evil good and calling good evil. And that is happening. And as you say, I don't really promote party politics. I say that you should have people in both parties insisting that all the leaders do the right thing. I am a conservative, and I'm happy to be one. But I believe that liberals should also be enlightened and know the truth. When you say that it is okay to kill a little person in the womb, it used to be you said you didn't know that was a human being, but the ultrasounds and science have just trumped that and proven that those
our babies are human beings. I bought that lie when I was a young woman, and I ended up having two abortions and a miscarriage due to the harm to my body from the abortions and the harmful fertility blockers that they call birth control. And so today I know that abortion kills babies and women. We've got Lakeisha Reeves, Lakeisha Wilson, Tanya Reeves, many African-American women who've been killed by abortion, Jennifer Morbelli, a Caucasian lady. There's a long list, a growing list of women who've been killed by abortion, slaughtered in abortion mills, and millions of babies have been killed. About one-third of those babies, even though African-Americans make up about 13% of the population, but we are tricked into having about one-third of those abortions. And then we want the politicians want to say this is women's rights and reproductive rights, and there's a war on women that is trying to keep women from exercising our reproductive rights. No, there is a war on women, and we see that war on women even most recently with the 300 little girls in Nigeria who were kidnapped, Christian girls and things like that. The war on women are, as you mentioned, in China, forcing the women to have abortions after one child. But we see that here on the war of our women, on the wombs of our women, with these women being slaughtered in the abortion mills. And Obamacare insisting that we give to women free birth control or access to birth control through our insurance policy. That birth control that is linked to breast cancer, cervical cancer, depression, high blood pressure, stroke, all of the chemical procedures that are either surgical or oral or shot, that that birth control that you're insisting is not health care, it's death care, to give women these products that make the woman's body feel as though it is sick so it cannot conceive, and it's going to be linked to blood pressure, stroke, diabetes, heart attack.
And they're not telling anybody about this. Did you see the woman who's an actress, who's an abortion counselor selling women on it in New Jersey, taking a picture of the baby and saying how much she gave birth? It was wonderful to, like, you know, kill the baby. I mean, what did you think of that? I've never seen anything that satanic.
That was on YouTube. And see, what she did not do, she did not show her abortion. She showed a picture of her. She may not have really been having an abortion either. See, that could have been doctored. But she's showing, oh, this is pleasant. This is fine. Now I know I can at least get pregnant. They didn't show the baby being torn up, ripped up, torn apart, killed. They didn't admit that many times that once the babies are aborted, they ship the remains of the babies to be burned as energy, the energy plant. You know, there's so much that's not being told to us, and it is satanic. There are many actresses, though, who have come forth and said that they really did regret their abortion. We have, was it Australia? Is an actress somewhere recently that committed suicide because she could not get over her abortion.
Oh, it's incredible. Dr. Alveda C. King is our guest. She's a pastoral associate of Priest for Life, director, African-American Outreach, priestforlife.org, an excellent site. She's got a new book coming out in just about 2-3 weeks, King's Rules, that I hope to read and maybe even carry on our online store and get her back on. In the 3 or 4 minutes we've got left with you, I know, at least from what I've read, that MLK, again, I'm not saying Republicans are great, but he was more Republican than Democrat from what I knew. He was pro-life from what I knew. But then when I watch CNN or MSNBC, they use his image to act like he would be for socialism and abortion. You know, being his niece, being very close in the family, can you say what you believe Martin Luther King would be saying today if MLK Jr. was alive?
Well, in my book, it's King Rules, K-I-N-G. There's 10 rules, R-U-L-E-S, 10 rules that will help you, your family, and our nation to prosper. And there's a whole chapter on life in that book. Father Frank Pavone wrote the afterward. Congressman J.C. Watts.
So it's about what he did. So it's about what would Martin Luther King say today?
Well, there's a whole chapter on if Uncle M.L., we call him M.L., Uncle M.L. could tweet. There's a whole chapter on tweets, 140 characters. Of things that he would say if he were here today. Absolutely. Now, he was not a Republican. He was not a Democrat. His dad was a Republican. And today I'm a Republican. But Martin Luther King Jr. in his own words said, I don't need to join either party because I might need to speak to people in those parties. So he was more like a Billy Graham or or different pastors and preachers, we don't know what their political persuasion is, because when they go to their White House or when they counsel these leaders, they want to do it from a position of the Bible, which is higher than any political party. So Martin Luther King Jr., in his own words, was an independent.
Yes.
He wrote that himself. Yeah.
Well, listen, in the time we've got left, tell us about the new book, when it's coming out, and just your take on Obama. I mean, I think of him as the opposite of Martin Luther King. The way MSNBC and Al Sharpton try to invoke racial division because they're busy stealing all of our futures, Obamacare, raising taxes on poor people. What's your take on Obama?
I just think it's amazing that people wanted to say that Obama was the realization of the dream of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. wanted a preacher of the gospel of Jesus Christ. President Obama has actually said that America is no longer a Christian nation. And I know that my uncle would be very upset to hear that. My uncle was a man of God, and he loved the Lord, and he was a preacher of the gospel. Civil rights leader, yes, but definitely a preacher. He was not a politician. So we have to remember that President Obama is a politician. Martin Luther King Jr. was a man of God. And you can no more compare President Obama to Martin Luther King Jr. than you can to Moses. Martin Luther King Jr. was more like Moses. And, of course, President Obama is not. So I just hope that people will reexamine history and to know that Martin Luther King Jr. was pro-life. His wife, Coretta King, was pro-choice, just like Mrs. Barbara Bush and Mrs. Lara Bush are pro-choice and think a woman should have the right to choose abortion, but their husbands do not. That was the truth of Martin Luther King Jr. He did not even go to the Margaret Sanger Awards program. When he was offered that award, his wife went and accepted the award because she was pro-choice.
Sure, so and people weren't as informed. And people weren't as informed, obviously, back in the 60s and things. We understand the larger eugenics program now, and you're a great voice exposing that. I've seen you on TV and heard you on radio, and now you've been here. Dr. Alveda C. King, thank you so much for coming on. I look forward to talking to you coming up in late June to do a full interview on your book.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. God bless you. Guys, get her set up right now. Well, there she goes, ladies and gentlemen. Very, very exciting to be getting that lined up for a full 30-minute interview with her. Now, I'm going to go back to your phone calls on the subject of the police departments nationwide. This is in the documents. We have the articles, Infowars.com. Training that veterans are what Homeland Security's for. Number one, enemy veterans. Number two, gun owners. Number three, Christian conservatives. Number four, it just moves down from there. Pro-life advocates, you name it. And then Al-Qaeda's not even on that list. That is sensational news, so I've been harping on that a lot. We'll take your phone calls for the rest of this hour. Then the next hour, I've got to get to the latest Benghazi news, the latest Holder news, the latest China massing on the Vietnam border news, GOP rollback school lunch programs. We're going to get to a ton of news, new NSA news. It's all coming up. But let's go out to break with this Soylent Green breakdown that dovetails with what Mrs. King was just talking about. Here it is. And then we will come back after the break. Aborted babies incinerated to heat UK hospitals. Soylent Green, ladies and gentlemen, is made out of people.
But now children are literally being passed through the furnace in order to fuel hospitals in the UK. They're being sacrificed on the altar of efficiency and prosperity.
Next thing, they'll be breeding us like cattle for food. You gotta tell them.
Well, we are telling them, Chuck. Charlton Heston was a pro-gun, pro-life activist, and of course he was a civil rights activist. About 10 years before it was cool, he was doing it in the late 40s, early 50s, going to places in Alabama and Oklahoma where he was being death threatened. That's why he's hated by Michael Moore, because he was a real liberal. Charlton Heston, a guy that I got a chance to talk to a few times on air, but also on the phone privately. He was so cool, man. He's just, I'm not a starstruck person, but Charlton Heston would spend like 25, 30 minutes on the phone with me, giving me pep talks. And I learned that he did that to a lot of other people. He cared so much. We'll be right back with your phone calls. A true veteran for liberty, Chuck Heston. We are the tip of the spear promoting liberty worldwide. We have the nightly news as a subscriber, 7 o'clock every night central. PrisonPlanet.tv, InfoWarsNews.com. It's $5.95 a month. Each membership, 11 people can simultaneously use with the same username passcode. I want to thank all the members of PrisonPlanet.tv. I want to encourage those of you that aren't members to become members. See all my films in HD, 19 years of work. Much of it's posted up there. The site's been around 12, 13 years. The site just gets better and better. PrisonPlanet.tv, InfoWarsStore.com has the best ProPure water filters, 10% off, promo code WATER. We've got InfoWarsLife.com with all the amazing supplements. We've got the Molon Labe shirts for men and women, the best design out there in my humble view. And your purchase makes the whole thing possible. So please continue to shop with the good guys, InfoWarsStore.com. Max in Wisconsin, thanks for holding. We're going back to the topic of the surreal Twilight Zone event of the government admitting the main enemy, the terrorists, are now the veterans. How did we go from the veterans marching off to supposedly fight the people that did 9/11, which was the Iraqis, not Saudi Arabia, who supposedly was behind it, and then now, 12 years later, it's flipped on to the Patriots? I mean, this is a scandal, much bigger than them having death list on veterans at the VA. We've told you that for years. They've had death panels there. It's terrible. But what about preparing for war on veterans? It just shows how maniac, out of control, the establishment is. Max, what's your take on this?
Yeah, I'm here in Wisconsin, and I don't know if you're aware of this, but they produce the MRAPs along with majority of the other trucks for the military here in Oshkosh, Wisconsin. And they have a stockpile of about 10,000 sitting partially at the Oshkosh airfield and partially.
No, you've done your intel. They made 6,000 of another type, a smaller one. I forget the name of it. They bought a bunch from Blackwater. They made out in, was it Virginia? And then I saw the order a few years ago for 10,000 to be cash and then deployed to police. And so you came up with a good number of 10,000. Is it still 10,000?
Well, they're always moving them. And what's nice that us, the taxpayers, we get to pay for parking nonstop for those 10,000 just sitting in the lot. They're already paid for. And I talked to one of the guys who works on them. He says that they can actually be hacked and drive up to 120 miles per hour. Now, imagine one of those suckers driving into your house at 120 miles per hour.
Yeah, you're saying it has a governor on it of probably 80 miles an hour, but you can bypass that and go 120?
Yep, and they just, I think last week, got the contract for the unmanned version, which they're starting to produce, I think, either this year or next year.
Yeah, everything's going to be unmanned. People think of a robot as Robbie the Robot. No, it's drones, it's ground attack, it's an armored truck with guns all over it, nerve gas, you name it. We're not going to be fighting troops or SWAT teams. There'll be no troops, there'll be no SWAT teams. There's going to be technicians overseeing robotic vehicles. And this is the way it's, I mean, they're done with us. I mean, this is the end of humanity as we know it. If this rolls out, it's an AI system. Do you agree with that analysis?
Yeah, I think we can turn around and maybe use this technology for good, you know, use maybe the military technology to fight wildfires, clean up our oceans, clean up our planet. And
oh, there'll always be good uses. The problem is it's directed by evil people. It's like you could argue, oh, give women birth control. But it came from eugenicists and literally Adolf Hitler. I mean, Margaret Sanger got awards from Hitler and was buddies with him, and they sent love letters to each other. And then they call her a liberal god in Time magazine. I mean, it's just... Look, of course robot trucks can be good to fight fires. They're not going to be used for that. They're going to be used to come against the people. And again, we're allowing an engineering system to create systems where humans aren't needed. Read Bill Joy's paper, Why the Future Doesn't Need It. Third hour, tons of news, your calls. Joe, Bruce, Michael, Jim, your calls are coming up. 800-259-9231. Stay with us. Tell friends and family to tune in. This is an info war. We're pro-human. We want a future. We got to wake up to the globalist master plan. It's not their world. It's hour number three. I want to go through at least five, six more calls. Joe, Bruce, Zach, Jim, Michael that have been holding. All veterans talking about how they're shocked so far that they're openly on the news. We played the clips earlier saying that the main enemy is the veterans and the police need armored vehicles and all these weapons to fight veterans because, there's such an explosion in veteran crime. And it's not even true. They just say, the crime rate's way up and veterans are horrible and, we have to be ready to kill them and Easter bunnies fly. And, it's incredible. But this is what a takeover looks like. Joe in Texas, thanks for holding her on the air. What's your take as a Marine vet on this?
Hey, Alex, it's been a while since I talked to you. Good news is got a fellow Marine brother of mine I served with in Central America, and he's got up around East Texas, and we're training civilians, or he is, rather. He'd asked me a couple years ago to come and help him, and he's training civilians, and I talked to him about 10 months ago, and he had told me that Joe, American people getting ready to see some things they've never seen in their life. And, he's seen it, I've seen it. And good news is that there's some veterans out there training civilians, and they know what's going on. And fortunately, and I've had people up here where I'm a neighbor hill country person like you, and they all think there's going to be, helicopters flying down the river. And I told them, I said, it's not going to be helicopters coming down a river. It's going to be foreign troops coming over the top of those hills, and you're not even going to know they're there. But fortunately, we're prepared. We know what's going to happen.
How would you describe this takeover we're watching in slow motion?
I would describe it as history repeating itself, and that, it's time, like it says in the Bible, for us to take our plows and turn them into swords. And I think that it's a repeat of history, and just like, the fall of the Roman Empire, way back there, 12, 14 years ago, I got the opportunity to read None Dare Call It Conspiracy, and it's all corporative, just like you spoke, Alex, and they just want to, they want us to come down to the point of being their slaves, and they're the masters, but I don't think it's going to work. I've built a home up here with my wife in the sticks, and I'm not ready to give it up. I mean, I could go to Veracruz and places like that, but I'm not going to leave my home, and my children are here and grandchildren, and I'm not going to leave. And this is history repeating itself. And
it is, and the globalists are so bold, because America's been asleep for so long, but they're illegitimate, they're a fraud. So the key is to work in the info war, to wake up as many people as we can. That may back them off. But there's a catch-22, though, where we back them off so far, they then feel completely cornered, so they launch the attack to begin with. All I know is, justice be done, may the heavens fall. We're just going to do the right thing, work for peace, prepare for war, and let the chips fall where they may. What do you say to that, Joe?
I say, Semper Fi, God bless America, and all the above. Christian, pro-life, and we're going to be the ones that are coming after, because I'm all the above, and several other veteran friends of mine the same way. And, we've even volunteered to help other veterans coming back. And, God bless the ones that are helping the civilians know what to prepare for.
Absolutely. They're scared of leadership coming from the military, from the veterans. We're going to talk to Bruce, Michael, and Jim, and a few others when we come back. Then a ton of news, audio, video clips, you name it. Stay with us. It's the big third hour, always jam-packed. All right, I'm going to go to five or six more callers from vets responding to all these different newscasts and Fox News and all these different channels going, we got to have armored vehicles and fully auto and weapons. And every town's got to have a SWAT team, even rural Indiana, because the veterans are going to start blowing us up with IEDs. And the cops are like, there's an explosion in crime from veterans. This violence, the veterans, and none of it's true. Crime's way down, veteran crime's way down. Let's talk about veterans blowing their heads off because they can't get medical care. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, it's coming out all over the country. I told you it wasn't just one facility in Phoenix. The death panels are there. I've had Dr. Doug Roeke on, all these different veterans groups over the years. You still got good, some good people working at the VA, but half the VA budget goes to PR and other government programs and golf courses for the bureaucrats and junkets and trips. They don't want the money getting to the vets, and they've got secret lists where they decide to not give people surgeries and health care, to ration care. Not because they don't even have the money. They just don't want you to get better. And now we hear, oh, it's Austin, and oh, it's D.C., and oh, it's New York, and oh, it's San Francisco, oh, it's Seattle, oh, it's Albuquerque. Of course it is. I can play Rahm Emanuel, Bill Gates, Ezekiel Emanuel, who helped write it, and others all saying, of course there's death panels. I played it last hour. Of course we're going to ration your care. I mean, that's in the stinking bill, just like a $5,000 fine per employee is, and just like raising it on payroll taxes and people making $18,000 a year is. There's like 16 new taxes total, seven of them on poor people. Read my lips, no new taxes. You know, that was what George Herbert Walker Bush said. Obama said, hey, I won't raise your payroll tax. I won't raise your income tax. I won't raise a sales tax, a VAT. No new taxes on anybody making less than $250,000 a year. Pure bull. Medical device taxes. On and on and on. And it doesn't work to just go, oh, people that don't like Obamacare are just racist. Okay, we need to go ahead and go back to your phone calls, and I'll get into all the other news, like PLA troops to send on China-Vietnam border. Yeah, this is getting crazy, and more. See, when there's a global financial meltdown going on, and you're sliding towards the abyss, all sorts of craziness is going to break out everywhere. Not just our crazy elite. Bruce in Tennessee, thanks for holding. You're on the air worldwide. Hello, Bruce. I can hear him in the background. Just put him on hold. Let's go to Jim in Indiana. Jim, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yes, this is Jim in Indiana.
Yes, sir. You're on the air worldwide. Go ahead. Thanks for holding.
Yeah, I'm 3 miles from the Morgan County Sheriff's Department, the subject of your report. I'm 2 miles from Martinsville, which is the county seat for Morgan County. And it just seems like there's more darkness than there's our fair share here. If you remember 4 years ago, two Martinsville police tased a 10-year-old at a daycare center. A year after that, a West Middle School student shot another student. And then we have this story. And that's just the tip of the iceberg with this little Mayberry-type town. So
you know, I just forgot. One of my buddies about 7, 8 years ago was outside the town you just mentioned, because I remember him talking about it. And they were having a barn party with a bunch of girls drinking beer. He just got out of the Army. And a SWAT team in an armored vehicle showed up and arrested a bunch of them, and then didn't even have any charges, but later let them out of jail. So I guess, well, I mean, if you do anything there, they said they were out in the middle of cornfields, you know, drinking beer. I mean, if you can't do that in America, where can you? And here comes the armored vehicles. What are the police like there?
The city police, I don't get anywhere near. They're all portly, beady-eyed, looking down at you type guys that think they're the gods of the universe. The sheriff's department, most of the guys are pretty good guys. In fact, I applied to be a reserve officer several years ago. So, yeah, I didn't even know that they had this MRAV vehicle you were talking about until you broke this story. That's how good of a show they put on.
Well, it is a creepy, quote, SWAT team commander out in the middle of a small town, you know, saying we need this for the veterans. That's super creepy. But I think most of these guys talking like this aren't veterans, and they have a real dislike of veterans because they always wanted to be soldiers, and they're not. So now they're playing soldier, and I guess they're just imagining and fantasizing how they're going to, you know, crush the veterans.
I feel tension in the interview when I went in to be a reserve. You know, I went in with a three-piece suit, fresh haircut, and it was obvious to them that I was a veteran, and I wasn't ashamed to mention that I spent 10 years in the Navy. But most of the guys on the panel, out of the five people that were interviewing me, looked, for lack of a better word, scared that I would show up in a suit and want to serve with them, knowing that I'm not afraid to say or speak the truth.
Well, that's the thing about a tyranny is that you get a lot of slobs and cowards who want to have the image of being a man but don't want to actually have to walk that walk. And, again, a lot of police I know are veterans and are some of the best people I know, so I don't want to paint with a broad brush. But, you know, anytime you see these guys lapping up Homeland Security baloney, you know something's wrong with them. I mean, how did that cop with a straight face talk about, well, the exploding crime of the veterans and all this violence increasing, we got to have this. The crime rate's down 52% in violent crime. I mean, you'd think a SWAT team guy would know that.
You know, fairly educated that guy was just reading off a script.
Oh, yeah, the whole thing.
The crime around here is way down. Everybody's got a concealed carry permit. Nobody messes with anything. And if there is crime, it's just petty break-in stuff.
I know. And the only places you have out-of-control crime are big cities. And the Austin Police Department overall does a really good job trying to focus on crime, in my experience. But they've been kind of covering up shootings and racial attacks downtown. Because I know folks that live down there, and it's getting creepy. Because here's the deal. This country's collapsing. Only three cities in the U.S. are really growing fast, Atlanta, Austin, and one other I forget that are top 10 cities. Austin's doubled the last 10 years. So it's not just people coming for jobs. Criminals, and I saw a statistic on this a few months ago in The Statesman, are flooding here. Irving, Texas is the other one growing fast. They don't need to cover up the fact that there's a lot of criminals coming here. The Austin Police Department needs to be honest about it. I appreciate your call. I mean, I'm going to tell you, I grew up in Dallas, folks. I know what serious criminals look like and act like, and I'm starting to see them. And I didn't used to see a lot of that, and it's creepy. Just thank God I got a gun in my car. Let's talk to Michael in Kentucky. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, Alex. I haven't talked to you in a while. Great show.
Thanks. What's on your mind?
I think a lot of... being a veteran, Army, and there's a lot of us that are out here that, you know, we get a little long in the tooth, and we worked real hard to get to where we're at, whether it's, you know, do the right thing, go through the educational system, get a degree, get on with work, you know, try to be a professional, raise your family, et cetera, et cetera. And you know, we... and play by the rules. And all of a sudden, you know, you look at a system that no longer plays by socioeconomic norms or anything like that.
They've broken the social contract with us.
Absolutely, absolutely. And they've, you know, they've done it to all of us. You know, my father, who was a veteran, lived out of Florida, and, you know, the VA got him. And, you know, all those things, and this is what I want to say to all my veteran brothers and sisters, is that you be ever mindful of what they're doing and keep a list and check it twice. You know, be Santa Claus here, because when it all kicks off, you know, we get to give gifts. And it's coming. Everybody knows it's coming. And the issue is that, you know, it's probably going to happen in the urban, suburban areas. They're going to come after weapons. They're going to come after people. That's going to be the first strike. And you know, boy, I tell you what, when they come out here to the country, though, it's going to get ugly for them.
Well, they're going to cut off the resources first of the country and try to starve everybody out, identify who's who. But, yeah, you're absolutely right. Really, you know, really good points you make. And, look, here's the deal. The globalists are anti-human. They want to replace us with machines. They want us to act like machines. They're anti-family, anti-woman. So who are they going to hate first? Warriors. They're going to hate the guardians of humanity, the protectors of men and women and children. They loathe people that are honorable. They loathe men that aren't cowards. That's why they, in every regime, when Hitler took over finally, he exterminated a bunch of the top military and even low level. I mean, it's the same purge over and over again. Once they take over, they go after the veterans. This has happened in every authoritarian country. Happened in communist China, happened under Pol Pot. It's happened throughout history. And this is not a fight anybody asked for. I, myself, am a veteran of the InfoWar. They're going to come after me, folks. They're going to come after Ron Paul, so many others. You know people like Matt Drudge at the top of the list, Joseph Farah. Anybody that they know is a true believer. We played Pentagon clips yesterday where they said they're scared. And they admit it. We're educated, highly motivated, and are moral. They don't like moral people. They don't like the fact that we stand for something because we won't fall for their takeover. And the people that sell out to this, you fell for the con. You're not going to have any future either, you idiots. God bless you, sir. I appreciate your call. We're going to come back and talk to a bunch of other folks straight ahead. Stay with us. More calls coming up. Of EU Parliament, Bilderberg is the root of all evil. Paul Watson will be interviewing him coming up in a few weeks at Bilderberg. He's planning to go cover it. And this MEP actually got arrested once trying to cover it in Switzerland, and Watson was there as well. We're sending David Knight and Josh Owens to Copenhagen, Denmark. Hard to believe it's already Bilderberg time. In less than 10 days, they're going to be out there covering it. It's at the end of May, into the 1st of June. We're going to have live video feeds from there and so much more. We are the media, folks. We are the future of the media. We go to the NSA building. We go to the secret military training camps with our great reporters. And then we have another video coming up in audio. I'm going to break down the just broken Infowars.com video. Border Patrol attempts to seize phone from libertarian filming inland checkpoint stop. I don't know if it's, quote, a weapon. That's the new thing. Again, 100 miles in, the illegals are being legalized by fiat, but the Border Patrol is now a domestic police force. And I'm not bashing the Border Patrol. They do a lot of good work. They got a tough job. My experience, they don't act super arrogant, which is just what, you know what, I don't like. They have been beating people up and stuff. It's just out of control, so that's all coming up. Right now, let's go back to your calls. Carl in Washington, thanks for holding. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Can you hear me, Alex?
Loud and clear, buddy. What's your take on the feds openly saying and the police saying they're training for war with their new enemy, not Al-Qaeda? Enemy number one is veterans. What do you think of that?
I think it sucks, but for all the sacrifices that all of us have given, I wanted to say something, Alex, and I think most of the war veterans will agree with this, that they have a right to be afraid of veterans, and that's what I found out when I went. I was in Vietnam, but what I found out was when you're faced with dying or living and these types of things, you find out who you really are. It's easy to talk about it when you're sitting home and how bad you might be or whatever. And most of these policemen, I mean, it's kind of a warning, I guess I'm saying, is it's one thing to train. It's another thing to face the music. And most of the veterans, to say that they're not afraid, I think they've just learned how to act, or they know who they are under that fear. So I'm calm. I'm like you are. I'm not going to roll over. I'm not going to give it up. If I got to die, I will die doing this as opposed to allowing them to march me into a FEMA camp or whatever they choose to do.
It'll be an emergency center for your safety. Just remember, there's going to be a lot of psyops in all this as well. But I don't want to talk about it like it's foregone. If we don't stop it, it's just going to be so horrible.
I want to stop it. I don't want this to happen. But I had one question I wanted to ask you. Do you think that this American Spring will make any kind of a difference?
You know, I've seen this whole American Spring thing, and it happened this weekend, and really nothing happened. And I think it's uncoordinated, and because it is so grassroots, it's easy for some, you know, bad parties that I've seen pop up in the past to try to, you know, hijack it and control it. And, you know, it's just really hard to say Americans are going to stop following orders and go protest everywhere. I think we should all just be doing that constantly, but mainly talking to friends, talking to family, going to the state house, calling talk radio, calling C-SPAN, saying no. Civil disobedience. You know, if you think something's unconstitutional or you're going bankrupt and can't pay all these taxes that are too high, the elite don't pay taxes. I'm not saying don't pay. I'm saying make your own decision. Start, you know, not going along. I mean, if the illegals don't pay taxes most of the time and are above the law, why should you pay them all when you can't pay them? I mean, it's really, and I never used to talk like that. It's getting to a point where it's just the system so lawless and so evil that it's totally illegitimate, and to follow its orders are suicidal. But there are a lot of good people I know involved. People keep asking me for like a month, you know, it's here, the American Spring. Well, the Arab Spring was a globalist, Google-funded stir up the Muslims to overthrow their countries to put in Al-Qaeda. And to have Saudi Arabia take over all those countries, that's not a good idea. I'm not saying people are bad that want to, you know, go out and call it an American Spring. It's kind of like Anonymous has the government involved in some of it, but most of Anonymous is good. I'm just saying anything like that, it's easy to say you're part of a group that's ambiguous and then have something slapped on you. So that's where I stand. Basically on that, you know, it's just like all these calls, hey, we're going to have trucks block DC and all this stuff, and then it doesn't really happen. It just, it all smells bad to me. Just when something smells bad, I don't promote it. If you hear me not promoting something, it's because my gut tells me stay away from it. We'll be right back. Showdown. China ships evacuate almost 2,000 from Vietnam. Troops massing near the border is what the Chinese papers are reporting. AFP says almost 2,000 Chinese citizens were evacuated from riot-hit Vietnam Sea on Monday, with another two ships following as Hanoi stifled fresh protest over a territorial dispute and foreign investors counted the cost. You got to hand it to the Vietnamese that they're territorial and don't want to be enslaved by outsiders. Americans used to act like that. The passenger vessels left the central Vietnamese port of Vung Vinh, each with more than 900 evacuees on board, China's official news agency reported. And it goes on. We have the article up at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com by Paul Joseph Watson. Italian MEP, Bilderberg is the root of all evil. European Parliament member blames secretive group for wrecking Italy's economy. As the secretive group gears up, I'm going to break that down in a minute. Continuing with the PLA. PLA troops descend on China-Vietnam border. Citizens evacuate over fears of imminent military conflict, close quote. Beijing may be considering a military response to anti-Chinese protests that have erupted in the Vietnam over the last 2 weeks, with reports of an endless stream of PLA troops, tanks, missile launchers, and other heavy artillery heading to Pingzang City. Am I pronouncing that right? Pingzang City, where the Sino-Vietnamese War of 1979 began. Yeah, I mean, the Vietnamese are just constantly fighting anybody that gets in their business. The Japanese, the French, you name it, the U.S. The protests were sparked by China's attempt to place a huge state-owned oil rig inside Vietnam's exclusive economic zone on May 2nd. Yeah, China's pushing Japan around, Philippines around, now Vietnam on May 2nd. A move Vietnamese treated as illegal act of provocation. The deployment of the rig was accompanied by 80 ships, including seven PLA warships, which were confronted by Vietnamese forces. Chinese ships used water cannons and rammed the Vietnamese ships, fueling a dispute that has raged ever since, with violent anti-Chinese riots, or China riots, leading to the death of 21 protesters. After Beijing sent two planes, see, they don't have fluoride in their water there, folks. It's normal to act like that when people are taking your stuff. After, or you're just your slave. I mean, it's, slaves don't act like that. Slaves bend over. After Beijing sent two planes after five ships to evacuate Chinese citizens from Vietnam last week, assets of very different nature are heading to the border region as reports emerge of PLA troops in full combat gear on their way to the edge of the city. This is out of control. And it goes on and on. Folks, this is how World War III starts. I'm not saying it's going to start, but other historians, analysts are saying this looks like World War. It's popping up in Eastern Europe, in Ukraine, Poland. It's popping up in the Middle East. It's popping up in North Africa. It's popping up in Western Africa. It's popping up all over Latin America, Central America. It's popping up in Asia. It's popping up. North Korea threatened to attack South Korea. You've got Vietnam fighting with China. You got China threatening Japan. Japan threatening to build nukes. You got China's general a month ago saying we may just invade Philippine Islands and take them. I mean, it is crazy town. Crazy town. I'm going back to your calls here in a moment. I've got more news I'm going to hit, but let's finish up with these calls right now. Truth Raider, South Carolina's a vet, Chad's a vet, Devin's a vet, and Michael's a vet. Let me give each person about a minute and a half so I have time to hit the other news I haven't gotten to yet and some video clips I want to play dealing with this Border Patrol situation. But let's go ahead and go to Truth Raider. Thanks for calling. You're on the air.
Alexander Emmerich, really, really quick. I have some important information, and it would behoove you to get in touch with Fritz Springmeier. He's got some very interesting latest information on his research that needs to be broadcasted worldwide.
Okay, well, maybe we should get him back on. Go ahead.
Okay.
Guys, yeah, call Fritz and find out what it is, and we'll try to get him on air. Go ahead.
Okay. I'll let him explain what it is. It's his information. I'll let him tell you what it is.
No, I wasn't. Hold on, sir. I was telling the crew, maybe it's time to get Fritz back on. We're going to find out what it is. Go ahead.
Is good. His Skype is good now, so you should be able to get a good communication between the two of you.
Yeah, okay. I mean, that's why we hadn't had him on in a while. It's just the interviews were bad phone or bad video. And it's just, you know, but go ahead.
Okay. My assessment on the big picture, what's going on, and I'm a veteran from over 20-something years ago, back in the late 1980s, and I realized that all I was a part of a police force for the international banks, the Rothschilds and Rockefellers. That's all this is just a big...
Exactly, and now they're going to drones and robots in the next 10 years. Now the war on veterans, the old army... They're phasing out humans, literally, this is public, so they got to wage a war and demonize and have the final war against warriors. Because it's a war against humans, period, by the globalists. And, of course, they hate warriors first. Of course, any occupying force wants to wipe out the warriors first. Go ahead.
Right, and that's it. They're going to have to resort to transhumanism, et cetera, whatever they're doing. The robot, I see these robot dogs or something like that are a robot type of critter.
No, sir, it's official that by 2020, no more combat aircraft that aren't drone, and they're going to ground everything. But go ahead.
Right. But this is the deal. The way I got out, and the reason why they're attacking veterans is because they know that all we are is pawns in their scheme. According to Henry Kissinger, all we are is stupid, dumb animals to be used to settle foreign conflicts.
Well, that's a quote. Countries. That's a quote. Great point. I appreciate your call. That's it. It's like a cannon. You know, you drive by the VFW, you drive by the State House, there's old cannons, and they've got lead poured down them, or they're spiked. They're done with you. They hate your guts, and here's why they really hate veterans. When they take everybody's pension funds and take everybody's bank accounts in phases, they're going to take it in pieces. This is a globalist program worldwide, psychologically. They take 20-30% at a whack, thinking you'll put up with it, and in a decade, you're totally bankrupt. They know that veterans, when their pensions are taken, are going to get mad. So they're coming for you. Chad in Tennessee, thanks for holding her on the air.
Hey, Alex.
Go ahead.
Got a couple of different issues to bring up. One, you know, I listened to the recording of the SWAT officer, whoever it was, speaking. You know, they do this fear-mongering. Actually, out of all the veterans, it's only a small percentage that would even know how to make an IED to begin with.
But there's no IEDs going off except for the Boston thing, which was as phony as a $3 bill. That's the thing. And the cops were like, they're going to be veterans killing everybody. And we got to patrol the cornfields. They're everywhere. Is there one under here? Is there one over there? No, the globalists are going to blow stuff up and blame it on vets. Go ahead.
The second point that I'd like to bring up is that... I believe right now this is a testing phase. I believe, you know, you have to propagandize the indigenous population that you are getting ready to try and make social change with. So I believe that right now they're putting out all this to see how are we going to respond.
Exactly. We got to freak out, make a big deal out of it, and push back, and they'll back off. Exactly.
So I believe that the best thing that people can be doing is going to their local police facilities, questioning all these operating procedures that they're starting to come up with if your town is getting these MRAPs and heavy equipment and everything else.
And I agree, and don't be apologetic. I mean, I would be serious and say, listen, you know this country's being taken over by tyranny. You know foreign banks are raping us. You know, here's the news articles, they're training for war on the vets. The vets aren't doing anything. They're trying to stage a takeover. They know the vets aren't going to be part of it. Serve your community and your family name and God. Don't be a little coward that becomes a federal pimp. I mean, police in the past would never be part of this. And we've got it. I agree with you. Go ahead. Sorry, I'm ranting.
No, it's fine. And I really like to say that people are going to have to get out there and talk to these people and ask them. You know, you don't have to be combative with them, but ask them, like, we have never had these types of threats going on all over the place like other countries, like Israel and Palestine. Why is it now that we are starting to push and say that our own people are going to start doing all this? Why is that? Why would anyone, if anyone was going to do any of these things, what would be their motivation?
Look, exactly. Force a debate. It'd be like if somebody came to a church and said, I'm worried an arson's going to burn this place down. You watch. You need to buy insurance. And then next week it burns down. Who's the first person the cops are going to talk to?
Oh, you're asking me?
Yes.
Well, of course, it's going to be the people they want to demonize.
Well, but I mean, listen, if I come to your house and you're a new neighbor that moves in and I said, there's been a lot of fires, Chad, with new people that move in. Hope nothing burns down because we don't like neighbors. If your house catches on fire, who's the main suspect going to be?
It's going to be the neighbors.
Okay. The globalists are saying the vets are getting ready to start a civil war and bomb the police as an excuse to train the police for war against the veterans. How obvious is it who's going to stage stuff? Because nothing's happening. They have a nationwide preparation for this. Who does that tell you is going to stage it? I mean, they say it's coming for sure. How do they know that?
Because they've already planned it. They already have.
Absolutely. Red-handed, total, and they've done it before. So, I mean, if they're going to fund Al-Qaeda to kill 300,000 people, mainly Christians, in Syria, do you think they'll stage something here? I have an article today saying, why does Christian persecution get worse in every country the U.S. liberates? The U.N. admits Christians are under the greatest persecution ever. The globalists hate Christians. They hate anybody that doesn't worship them. John Kerry's running around saying, keep faith in his Yale speech in government. It's their God. Their God. They want us to worship Bill Clinton. No, you understand? So of course you're the enemy. Anything else? I'm sorry, I'm ranting.
No, that's it. They want you to worship the state. The state is God. The state, there is nothing above the state, and that's why they hate Christians.
That's right. God bless you. I appreciate your call. I mean, we are in the hands of just desperately wicked people. I don't know how to explain it anymore. I mean, it's so over the top that in cartoons and movies, just everywhere, the listeners send them in every week, sitcoms, dramas. It's like the bad guy that's going to nerve gas New York's a veteran who's a Christian. The guy that's a child molester is a veteran and a Christian. The guy that murders his wife's a veteran and a Christian. The guy that tortures children is a veteran and a Christian. The guy cooking methamphetamine is a veteran and a Christian. The bad guys in cartoons now against the Fantastic Four, you know, wear tri-cornered hats and love George Washington. I mean, it's so obvious that they're not doing all this without planning to pull something. I mean, this is like, if I see a raccoon climbing up on top of a trash can, I go, watch, they're going to try to dump that trash can over and eat the trash. I'm no rocket scientist, folks. I've seen raccoons tump over trash cans. I mean, it's like saying that guy's walking up to his door, he's about to put a key in it and open it. Well, how do you know that? Because he lives there. I mean, this is a no-brainer, folks. Like when I see a perch come up to my line to bite it with my kids. That perch is about to hit that line. Watch as he's coming in. Boom! Reel the perch up. I mean, they're openly saying conservatives, libertarians, Christians, veterans are terrorists. There's going to be a war with us. We're going to stage terror attacks. 2 + 2 = 4. They've got a history. They stand to gain. They've done it before. They're rolling it out. When it happens, they did it. There is one chance out of 20 that there's mentally ill copycat veterans out there that hear so much in the movies where veterans are going to bomb stuff that they might actually do it. There is a chance that you mentally ill people might actually. Big deal. You got a better chance of being struck by lightning than being bombed. You got cops running around in giant armored vehicles shaking in fear when you ought to be scared of the 18-wheelers coming on the highway while you're writing tickets. That kills, I forget the number, I think it's almost 1,000 cops last time I saw a year are killed being run over writing tickets. And only in the last few years do cops go around to the passenger side and not sit there with their butt sticking out in the middle of the highway. I mean, you ought to be scared of those 18-wheelers. You ought to be scared of deer jumping in front of you. You ought to be scared of cancer and the glyphosates in the water. Oh, but it's invisible. It's not sexy to be afraid of that. I mean, you're literally under mind control. Let me tell you what I do now, and I'm going to do it more and more. Most of the time I'm busy going somewhere, but when I see a cop bowed up, sticking their chest out, acting weird, it's usually only federal people, armed park rangers I see do that on the Texas coast and other places. I go over and say, why are you so imperious? What's that mean? You know, arrogant, like you're king. They're like, who are you? Well, what's your problem? My problem is you act like a really weird person. Like, I've been to third world countries and cops act like you're acting. Now, what is your problem? Did they hire you because you're OCD and like to boss people around? What's OCD? Well, you need to look it up. Or you have a borderline personality disorder? What's wrong with you? I mean, I just can't handle it. I can't handle people trying to say I'm their slave so they can feel powerful. Let's go ahead and talk to Devin in California. You're on the air, Army vet. What's your take on all this?
Nice to speak with you, Alex. Yes, my name is Devin. I served in Iraq. I was very young when I went in, very naive, believed I was fighting on the side of the world police. I have quite a few points I want to bring up to you. First, I would like to bring up the story about David Knight, Staff Sergeant Joe Biggs. Technically, they were arrested because they were detained against their will at Fort AP Hill. Now, my experience, I was stationed at Fort Hood, Texas, with the 4th Infantry Division. My experience with mount sites is that they dress them up depending on the war zone that you're going to be infiltrating. So when I was stationed at Fort Hood, they made them look like the Middle Eastern homes and buildings and so forth. Another thing that they had done was they had hired individuals who look Middle Eastern. So the one thing that I will...
No, exactly. They're hiring Caucasian, black, Hispanic role players with John Deere hats and training in Baptist churches. What does that tell you?
Exactly. So that's how you condition the soldiers, depending on the environment that you train them in. So to keep an eye out for that, see what type of people that they hire for
exactly.
That
well, I mean, they admit they're openly training for war on libertarians, Christians, conservatives, returning veterans, gun owners. So that's what I'm saying, folks. The government is pure rogue now, preparing for war with us. What should we do about that?
Yeah, well, now that I've been living in California, which is a pretty tyrannous state, you know,
yeah.
I have to deal with all the gun laws here. Anyways, another point I wanted to bring up was the Indiana police sergeant in Morgan County, which definitely, you know, threw me off my chair when he was talking about war with veterans because we've been, with our knowledge, to build IEDs. Now, when was the last time a returning veteran actually improvised an IED and set it off in the American streets? I can't remember.
Well, actually, teaching everybody about IEDs and hyping it will actually introduce it as a new weapon. That's what I'm saying. You'll have real people start IEDing because it's like when they teach kids don't commit suicide but show them how to do it, suicide explodes under death education. Border Patrol attempts to seize phone from libertarian filming inland checkpoint stop. Now, the illegals are all being legalized by fiat. Felons are allowed to go free. When I was down at the Texas border, no more Border Patrol down there. They were just writing people tickets for, you know, camping wrong or whatever. It's here. But then the Border Patrol will be used even 100 miles in. 70%+ of the country lives on a border or the coast. And they want to search your car at these. This has happened to me. In fact, the videos are posted in the article where I say no. But I laugh at them and stuff and say, come on, guys. I know the narcotics are getting shipped in by the government. You know I'm a U.S. citizen. And they, you know, end up backing down because I get out of the car and laugh at them. You stay in the car and sit and just talk to them, you get attacked. Windows knocked out, you name it. Here's the audio and video of the exchange. This is in El Paso, Texas. So this is closer to the border. Only a few miles away, but it is an inland checkpoint after they've gone through the first one. And this is what happened. Here it is.
Well, the inspection is not going to happen.
Yeah,
so
the inspection is not going to happen, sir. We're in the United States.
Inspection is going to happen. Inspection is going to happen.
What is that?
And the sheriff's on the way.
This is outside El Paso, away from the border.
Of your personal lot of the vehicle. Okay.
Okay.
And we'll take it from there.
All right. My lawyer's been called. This is not happening.
When you live down there, you go through them every day.
My authority, right? Because I'm not federal. Get out of your vehicle.
That's the local sheriff.
I'm confused as hell.
Right.
I'm really confused.
You know, have we broken a traffic law?
Have we broken a law?
What is this?
Have we broken a law?
Right? No, this is probable cause.
They think
right?
Checkpoints
are
normal.
Are just snowballing onto it.
Snowballing
onto what?
Onto what? Vehicle.
Are we being detained?
Are we being detained for some reason?
Yes, you are. Let's go. You're being detained because a canine has hit on your vehicle.
Oh, yeah.
Get out of the vehicle.
Those fat, these are talk show hosts doing this, by the way.
The same thing on a
these are fat dogs that get biscuits.
Out of your car.
Yes, sir. All right.
Now they're going to get his phone. Now, this is where they really cross the line, not just their checkpoint. Well, they grab the phone away. Coming up in a few minutes.
Can I have your phone?
No, you may not.
I don't know if it's a weapon or not.
It's not a weapon.
I'm letting you know right now. I don't know if it's a weapon, if it's a knife, or it's a gun. Let me have your phone.
You can put it in
there. Yeah, because a slave can't have a phone.
That's not happening. You're not bringing
it
out.
Then we're not getting out of the car. You're not having my phone.
I don't know if it's a weapon or not.
You'd know full well if not a weapon. Are you kidding me?
It's an iPhone.
It's not happening.
Tell you, there's a lot of pretty places near the borders and the coast, but man, I mean, having to deal with these border patrol every day.
Could you please put your hands off me?
Anything but illegal aliens is all they harass. Look at these guys looking for drugs. Ha! Go look at the major banks.
Yeah, I know.
By the way, most paper money has cocaine on it. Because, you know, it goes through all that. And they can say they can take any money you've got if there's any drugs on any of it. See, it's just it's all designed to make us guilty. Oh, boy. Look at that dog. I had cops want to search my car once, and they went and got a drug dog, and the dog alerted. There's about as many drugs in my truck as there are Easter bunnies. There goes the dog. All an excuse. Then they grab his camera away. We're out of time for this hour. I'm going to come back in a little bit of overdrive and get a couple other articles. But see the full video and the whole article at InfoWars.com. And this just broke. Nintendo promises to push gay agenda on children. Now the characters can kiss and, well, do things together. The little boy characters for your children. That's Nintendo now bringing you the sexualization of small children.
You are
they used to call that
GCN.
Pedophilia. Now they call it racist
visit
if you don't support gambling.
GCNlive.com today.
So there you go. We'll be right back. Infowars.com/show for audio feeds. All right, I'm going to hit a few final calls here, but I started mentioning this. I wanted to get into it now. Italian MEP, Bilderberg is the root of all evil. European Parliament member blames secretive group for wrecking Italy's economy. As a secretive group gears up for its annual confab in Copenhagen next week, Italian member of parliament, and it's Mario Borghese, I believe you pronounce it, has slammed the Bilderberg group as being the root of all evil. How do you pronounce that? Borghese? How do you pronounce that, guys? Borghezio. It's up on Infowars.com. He's a member of the Committee on Civil Liberties, Justice, and Home Affairs in the European Parliament and a prominent Italian politician and appears in a video in which he denounces Bilderberg as the root of all evil. It's Borghezio. Is supported by Italian lawyer Alfonso Luigi Mera, who last year requested that the public prosecutor of Rome investigating the Bilderberg group for its role in criminal activity. Mera accused the group of plotting to install Mario Monti, who they did, as prime minister of Italy, as Bilderberg's 2011 meeting in Switzerland, and labeling the organization a unique illegal brotherhood of elitists who consider themselves above the law. Powerful article that I just babbled through. It's up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Again, that's Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. And he's the guy that got arrested and basically beat up by the federal police in Switzerland, but then the state police came in when he tried to go into Bilderberg. So this is the type of stuff happening. Identifying the enemy, identifying the true mafia above the classical Italian mafia, the globalist mafia that actually runs things. Michael in North Carolina, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hello?
Yep.
Hey, Alex, this is Michael in North Carolina. Thanks for having me on there.
Thanks for calling in.
I just wanted to go over a couple things and just have a couple questions for you. I watched Terror Storm and was the other one, Sleep in Mind, last night. Those two movies back-to-back, and after watching them, I wanted to throw up. I just can't believe just our liberties, how many liberties are gone in our country, and warrantless searches and wiretapping, the list goes on and on. And how many cases does this happen where, you know, somebody, I mean, is it happening now with warrantless searches? I mean, it seems like they're throwing out probable cause. What was the name of the other reasonable suspicion? This seems like what they're going on now.
So. No, I mean, there's an attitude of we're the good guys. We're going to search you without warrants. We're going to whatever, because they've been given illegal authority because there's a takeover taking place. And that's it. We're becoming a third world country. But it's going to be beyond that. I appreciate your call. One more call. Ben in Virginia, you're on the air. Go ahead, Ben.
Hey Alex. How you doing?
Good.
I just wanted to call in and tell you about my experience at both Fort AP Hill and the training center in Camp Lejeune. I've been to both of them before. AP Hill has been turned into this big federalized complex. It used to be the home of the Boy Scout Jamboree every year, and it was one of the most civilian-friendly bases, and now apparently you get arrested just for coming onto the base, is what it seems like. And also this other one in Camp Lejeune, I had gone through that mount course several years ago before they put up these churches and everything else, and it seemed like a very basic scenario where the instructors would walk you through different things and how to do them. Now it seems like all it is geared and focused towards coming after the American people. All these other...
You heard the cop. It's for war with veterans. God bless you. Thanks for that information. Sorry to Nathan and Mike and others. I'm out of time. Great job to the crew. Tonight, InfoWars Nightly News, 7 o'clock. Be there. Tell your friends and family.